How many people, just throwing this out there, how many people in the world, the ratio between left-handed people and right-handed people? Any, just throw the figure out there to me. Are there more right-handed people than there are left-handed people?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So they're going to make it for the right-handed people. What are they going to do for the left-handed people? See, these are some of the things that we need to think about, all right? When we talk about stuff that a minute ago was so far-fetched. Now, I need you to do me a favor since we're connecting, and I need you and the black hat to do me a favor, all right? Please tell me, have you watched the Jetsons, the cartoon, before, right? She says, definitely. Tell me that technology we're not using today. How long ago was the Jetsons out?
30 years.
40 years.
So you see how far we behind? You see them fly hair stools that, what's the lady named, the wife?
Yeah.
Jane. Jane was wearing some fly hairstyles, the same ones y'all wearing today. Same flip phones, the same riding on the scooters that fly and all that kind of madness. That technology is today. You are 40, 50 years behind. So if you are, then this technology is old. If they put it in a movie before, then this technology is old. Am I right or wrong? Let me get and finish making my point. I'm going to tell y'all straight. Is that camera rolling? Okay, I'm going to just say it right in the camera. And I'm not stuttering when I say this. I'm not going to mince no words with y'all. I truly believe Dr. Khalid Muhammad and Johnny Cochran died in the very same way you see in this gentleman getting zapped right here. The brain aneurysm was caused by this low vibratory frequency sound waves that they can shoot at the brain, causing you to throw up and have convulsions and brain aneurysm. I'm telling you straight up. And this technology has been there. It's political assassinations, slow kill microwave weaponry. Yes, sir. And can alter the neurological system. Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying. And the nervous system. I'm talking about a person sitting in that black car right over there, all right, causing his sister here to lose her damn mind, to disrupt this meeting. Yes, that's exactly what the hell I'm saying. So we need to understand this particular, listen, more so deeper than that, brother, the new guns that they're about to put on the street will only fire if you have the chip in your hand to activate the mechanism inside the gun to turn the gun on.
That's why they want
them
on that.
Are you following me? So this is why when you join the police department, all federal agencies, you got to take the chip. Now, who did you say you work for? We have to keep these particular, you the first one that's going to get it. You the first one that got to take the shot if you want your job. You the first one to get vaccinated. You the first one to take the chip. The information has been among us for a very, very long time. Signing checks is a very old thing. Even when you do, please look at the line that you're signing. If you put a magnifying glass over it, it's actually a contract. All right, but that's another talk. But here you're seeing 1998, 1997. They were dropping hints then of the madness that they do. We have to keep these particular things in mind. If you're not hipping your children to wearing different crystals, amethyst crystals and everything that can prevent them from having brain cancer and some of the things that's going on in this particular slide. We have ways to prevent this, but we're not passing this information on. The amethyst crystal and other crystals can prevent this from happening. Diodes and other things that you can put on the phone and put on your computer. I interviewed Deborah Blair recently, and he was teaching me about these things. So we can prevent some of these things from happening. We just have to start thinking outside of the box. Silent weapons for quiet wars. And this is exactly what's going on. This is why they had to take out William Cooper, who wrote Behold the Pale Horse. He was dropping too much science and too much information on the American people. So the Alphabet Boys had to come after him. The same with Robert Strechter. The one that was doing the science on AIDS, saying that AIDS is a man-made disease, and they made it in Fort Detrick, Maryland. And one more thing about this, well, I guess I'll show it in the next couple of slides. So the whole idea it coming out in the news that the NSA is spying on different leaders in different countries and spying on the American people and tapping your phone. That ain't nothing new. They've been listening to your phone conversations. Hell, if you listen close enough, instead of running your mouth and gossiping, you can hear them. That ain't nothing new. But we never thought that the National Security Agency would do such a thing. Stop that. If we open up those files, we can show you that they've done that and more. And I think that's what happened to Barack Obama. They opened up them secret files, and the man is turning white. His hair is turning white. I'm like, what is it that this brother's seeing every day that he's getting so old? You understand what I'm saying? He said he opened up them secret files on the assassination of Dr. King and Malcolm X and a few other people, and he can't take it. Smart brother, good brother at heart, but he can't, let me tell y'all something straight up. Are you rolling? That war that's going on in the District of Columbia has nothing to do with black people. That's white people at war. The ones that want to destroy America and the ones that want to prop America up and keep using America to extracting money from the sheeple. We need to, that's not your war. That's not your battle. All right, you have absolutely nothing to do with this. As a matter of fact, they don't even consider you. And we need to keep that in mind. Matter of fact, I'm going to go deeper and say you're not even an American citizen. You just cannon fodder. And you really need to understand that. Plain and simple. So when they're shutting down their country, their government, that's their thing. All right? Let me just, can I just ask y'all a question real quick? When the government shut down, did you still eat? I did too. So what? And? We're going to survive. We like baby's kids. Y'all know that. We're going to survive. We're going to find some kind of way. Are you following me? And we need to understand that, man. We have tenacity for real. But the NSA's $2 billion database that's there in Utah. All right? We need to understand what's going on around this globe. I'm going to move real quick because there's a few things I have to get to before he starts telling me to wrap it up. Let me tell you why I put this here. Because there's a brother. Now, there was this fine sister walking in front of him. I don't know if it was her butt or his cell phone that made him walk into this damn pole. But I'm sitting at the light, and I'm like, ain't that much damn concentration into this. And I see it happening all the time. I got to tell my children, look up. You seen the thing at, where was it at? I should have made a slide. I think it was where the dude got hit.
Talking about on the subway where the guy pulled his gun out and was waving it on the subway.
No, not that. What's the young lady that got hit by the car using a cell phone from the group Black? Lisa Left Eye's group. She's on a 4-lane highway on the phone. And the car hit her, knocked her down the block. She lost her life on the phone. This is critical, man. But anyway, let me skip over a few. Can I skip by this real quick? Because you all know that the Federal Reserve is not part of the United States government. It's no more federal than Federal Express. We know this, right? Okay, cool. Let's move forward. Wait, one last question. I really would like for them to stop putting me in that. It ain't our damn debt. Who? Even if you do put me in it, who is it that we owe the money to? No. I'm not moving to another damn slide until we get that question answered. If America's in debt, trillions of dollars, who the hell do we owe the money to?
Everybody else.
Like who, though?
China's
one.
And it's going to be going forward.
I think the brother hit it right on the head. Everyone that the Department of Defense decides to go to war with, the Pentagon and the rest of these people. So is it safe to say that the war is inevitable? Not a question of if, but when it's going to happen, right or wrong? All right, cool. Y'all making my job real easy. I just said a few minutes ago that they consider us sheeple, useless eaters. And if you read their documents carefully and closely, you'll see this. All right, and you'll read this. Let me move to some of the other things. This is what I talked about earlier. The South Side, totally ignored by a criminally murderous pharmaceutical industry for medicinal tropical fruit kills cancer cells up to 10,000 times more effectively than expensive failure called chemotherapy, radiation, or any of these other kind of madness. Some fruit. But if you would, yes, ma'am.
I'm sorry. They tell you don't do fresh. When you have cancer, they say something it affects you more so than when you don't have a cancerous living. Mm-hmm. So they say no fresh fruits. And they say no fresh flowers.
Mm. But wait, they lied about that because they, as soon as your ass died, they put some fresh flowers on your grave, right around. So that's a lie in and of itself. But I'm saying, why would they have a need to tell us that though? Is the answer in it?
Yes.
They see. They want. Listen. They want you to stay perpetually ill, so they can constantly make money off of you. And we have to keep this particular thing in mind. Let's move quick, real quick. That spells itself out. I don't need to talk about that. We're gonna talk about dreams of my father and why in every lecture I call Barack Obama Barry Davis, and I've caught some flack for that, but that's cool. Some of them people that gave me flack when I put out my book Analytics and I talk about the Obama deception are some of my best friends right now. They came on back around and I accepted their apology. Because right now he signed off on AFRICOM, and AFRICOM right now is recolonizing the African continent. So I asked those people to please shut the hell up and you'll see for yourself. And I waited on them, and sure enough, when we got the data that all of the companies and all of the different races that are there on the African continent, all right, won't allow you to come back. They're writing legislation and law right now that if you go back, you can't own none of the land. Ain't that embarrassing? But the Chinese are there. The Portuguese and other people are there. The Russians are there. The Europeans are there. South Africans are coming up from South Africa to North Africa to claim the land. The precious minerals are there. Shell is there, Chevron, Mobil, I can go on and on. They're there. You ain't there. They're there. Now, I know I'm going way to the left, but this is actually real. This nanotechnology that they've came up with, putting cameras and microphones on mosquitoes. All right? I know it sounds kind of far-fetched, and I don't want y'all in your house tonight like swatting at flies and all that kind of madness, but it's very real. You see, what we have to do is, Minister Farrakhan said that Elijah Muhammad told him that we won't be able to fathom the depths of their wickedness. We won't be able to believe this, and I put it right in front of you on the screen and show you. This is somebody's fingertip that they're holding this mosquito on. It was Francis Cress Wilson that said that when the scientists studied the AIDS virus, all right, they forgot to tell the American people that the AIDS virus, the particles and the things that make the AIDS virus is so tiny and small, all right, that even if you put on a condom, the condom has to breathe. So it's almost like wearing nothing anyway. So brothers, you might want to scratch your head for a minute, man, that last prostitute or something that you may hit or whatever you doing out there. We need to think of it. I'm serious. We need to understand these things. These people are wicked, man.
Yes.
I mean, diabolically wicked. Anyway, this is HARP if you've never seen HARP. And they use it for weather modification, but they also use it to control mind control. Right. My question is, and the reason why I didn't put the name of it or anything on it, because I need y'all to tell me, how many HARP research projects do they have on the globe? Can anyone tell me?
I know there's one in Alaska.
One in Alaska.
One down south somewhere.
some down south. Come on, talk to me. Give me a place. Seven. Absolutely correct. It's seven of them. Your homework assignment is I want y'all to find out where they are. All right? Nah, don't yell out anything. Just tell them, just my phone number 678-557-2919. Text it to me. All right? I'm going to run through these real quick. I keep saying that. But the Obamacare, on the surface, it may seem like a good plan that now everyone could be covered. But we never thought that these the diabolical ones would force us, even if we don't want it, will force us to take the insurance policy. Regardless of what the rate is, not only forced to take the insurance policy, the thing that comes behind that, they constantly talk about this medical device. Did you read it? Or am I the only one that read it? I'm sure you read it, right? Huh?
Medical device tax.
The medical device tax. What is the medical device? Is the question I want to ask.
The chip.
The implantable biomicrochip. You have to take this particular device and put it in your body. And oh, listen, they coming. And they're going to get Reverend Pigfoot and Reverend Hamhock on Sunday to line y'all up to take the chip. I'm telling you. They're going to get your supervisor and your boss to line y'all up. I'm telling you, man. Let me skip over some of this. Because y'all already know that the alphabet boys are in cahoots with one another, right?
Yes.
There's no need for me to go over that. The people that work at CNN run and control CNN, the same people that run and control Fox. They in cahoots with one, they relatives. They took the same oath and the same handshake. We don't need to go over that. We know that HARP connected with these cell towers, they're using that to control the minds of the people. All right? What they actually did that we probably don't know is the cell towers created grid to track you. So all that lip service and all that stuff you be talking about, the government on Facebook and YouTube, y'all need to be cool.
Right.
The diabolical ones will tap, program your damn cell phone number in while your phone is in your pocket and send you some radiation. Are you following me? Or a bomb. And that's very real. I'm not being spooky about this. The dude on the phone, in the car, trying to get away from the drone aircraft, but he on the phone. All they did was program your number in, fool. And the frequency that goes out with your cell phone number to hit whatever tower, the bomb is tracking you. So the plane could be 9, 10, 50 miles away. It don't make a difference. Once your number is programmed in, it's a wrap. So let's talk about Facebook for a minute, real quick. Were you surprised that they were working with the NSA?
No.
So let me just put something on your mind. Does this Zuckerberg dude really invented this with some other white cats in the college dorm and that same story that they keep telling about everyone that has one of these kind of social networking companies? Stop that. Please stop that. Do not be that damn foolish. This is CIA all damn day long, man. This is, I'm telling, CIA all day long. Data collection agency. Facebook. If, brother, if you plan on putting this on YouTube, I know my Facebook's gonna get shut down, but I'm saying.
I won't unless you want.
No, put it up, bro. Yeah. So I'm just saying. So the whole idea of the NSA director admits agency, Charles Twitter, and Facebook. We've been knew that y'all got everyone's Twitter account. This is why you want everything to be connected. All right, what's the plan that they say on the phone? Your telephone plan. What is it? No, come on. The bundle. Everybody has the bundle now. They want you to bundle all the stuff because they tired of looking for your ass. They want you to tell them what your Facebook is, what your Twitter is, what your Instagram is, because they don't want to look no more. They want you to bundle it and tell them. And you do. Yes.
I don't use it, but there's reasons why I don't use it. I got a Galaxy 4.
Mm-hmm.
And I turn the Galaxy 4 on, and it's like, you got an email, you got a Gmail, you got a this.
Wow.
You have it. I couldn't even make a call yet. Like, if I couldn't make a call yet.
Right.
They asked me to go to Twitter, Facebook, do you have this? Okay.
And you got to approve it.
Stuff I have.
Right.
I'm like, no, I don't have that.
Right. And if they make a mistake and lose your password, they'll have you send it back to them. Tell me that didn't happen to you. No, come on. Gmail did that to me recently. And I'm like, wait a minute, I didn't change anything. So what y'all need it for? And then they'll lock you out of your account. Yes.
I had Gmail tell me somebody hacked my account.
Right.
Facebook, Twitter, all at one time.
Right.
You know, they like reset it. As soon as I did it, I'm like, wait a minute. How did I all come back that quick? There's no way somebody hacked me.
They did it.
They did it.
Thank you. The head of the National Security Agency denied on Wednesday that the intelligence services compiles data on Americans' use of the social networks. National Security Agency Chief General Keith Alexander told Senate Judiciary Committee that his agency once tested once. That's the key word. When you're reading this kind of stuff, you gotta look for the keywords, the words that pop out at you. Once tested whether it could track American cell phones or locations, claims the NSA does not use this technology. And the reason why they do not use that technology, because they're past that. They don't need to use it anymore. They passed that. It's almost like a waste of my time to kind of go over this madness, because we knew they were spying on Americans a long time ago. Rupert Murdoch got busted, but you didn't know that Rupert Murdoch was in cahoots with some of his relatives in America. You thought it was just in England.
Right.
And if you only think that they're using Facebook to spy on you, stop being deceived. All the other ones spy on you also. Apple, Google, Skype, Yahoo, and all of them damn porno sites, brothers, that y'all be going to late at night thinking you being slick. It's hard for me to even get it out. They're actually timing how long you stay on the site. We'll talk about that. We'll talk about that in the men's meeting. How about that? That's cool. We'll talk about that in the men's meeting, man. All right. Everything you shared on Facebook soon will be searchable by friends. All right. So if you search it, find it, put it on Facebook. All right. Everyone that liked it, watched it, seen it, whatever, will be connected. And they ask you on Facebook when you add someone, who is this person? Are you related to them? Are they your friend? They want to know more data. So now when they come after you, they know who your friends are. They know what you like, what you eat. When's the family reunion? Because it's all the stuff you gave them. I'm sure you'll get the point, right? This is what I put up on my page. Warning, this Facebook user makes posts critical of religion, politics, science, mainstream news, and will offer you posts on alternative ideas that will often conflict with everything you have been led to believe is true. Thank you. He tried that and they arrested his behind. Man arrested by FBI for posting on Facebook about government conspiracies. I thought government conspiracies weren't true. I thought there was conspiracy. Then why did the man get arrested? It's something about the conspiracy that 20 years later, all of a sudden now, it could be plausible, it could be true, it could be possible. We're coming up on the 50th year of the anniversary of the assassination of Kennedy, I think. Okay. All right. This is a television. My job is to help destroy what's left of your imagination by feeding you endless doses of sugar-coated mindless garbage. And that's very, 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 very real. And all of the alphabet boys, I'm doing this lecture with Sarah Sutton Seti, December 21st in St. Louis. And my subject that day is the triple alphabet theory. We're gonna connect all the alphabet boys and pull the cover off of all of them to let y'all know that they're all in cahoots. I'm talking about all of them. IMF to the CNN people, the ABC people to the World Monetary Fund. We're gonna connect them all. The TSA people to the CIA, the Mossad, the KGB, all of the alphabet boys. But because they go by these alphabets, you can't make the connection. And then we're gonna break down to number three. And why it's so important they use this particular number to resonate with black people to suck your psychic energy and power from you. Because you fall into it without you knowing it or not. Let me just give you the taste test real quick before we move on. How many people in the room born Christian with a Christian name? Just raise your hand real quick. Okay, then everybody got their hand up, got three names, right? What's your name, love? Stephanie Marie who?
Stephanie.
What's your middle name? Three names. Why the number three? Get the third degree of Freemasonry. When you get pulled over by the police, they take you, your ass downtown and give you the what? The third degree. See, that number three is very important. When you see a flag, it's three panels, right or wrong? So we get into numerology and the number three, but you need to be awake and aware to these things, not Griff.
Right.
Are you following me? So we need to talk about the alphabet boys. We'll talk about that a little bit later on, social media edition. All right. Molly, it has been a common drug lately and everyone is trying it. You pop one and you're sweating. Let me explain why you're sweating. It's a drug that has cocaine, crack, ecstasy, and bath salt all in one. Now I want to ask you something. Your son or your daughter passed ninth grade science chemistry class, all right? If that's true, then who is it and they can't even make goddamn powdered pancakes?
Right.
I'm just saying, who was bright enough to put this together? Wait, I'm talking about Aunt Jemima pancakes, where you just add water. I'm just saying that to prove my point. Who put that combination together? Crack? Cocaine, crack, ecstasy, and bath salt all in one. It said it stops your heart rate. Pop one and it damages your brain without you realizing it. It becomes addiction as soon and soon a cry for help. It weakens your immune system, destroys your organs, increases the chances of heart attack or failure of the lungs. It is a serious drug and dangerous, more powerful than crack itself. Then this rich, fancy rappers are advertising it and making idiots out of their customers. Rappers making songs about popping Molly. No, this is the drug I was telling you about, the crocodile. A flesh-eating drug. Who would readily and consciously say, look, man, I want some crocodile. How many you got? Oh, y'all gonna need a dub sack. All right. But look what it, I mean, I have some other pictures that I couldn't even put in the lecture. Yes, sir. Right. And it's going to be harder to detect and bust these people because it's stuff that you can just buy from the store. So I asked the sister, I'm like, your high is not high enough? How high do you have to get? No, you're talking to a brother that's never been high, so I don't know. So you're talking to a brother that never smoked and I never took a drink, so I don't know what it's like to be high. Can somebody tell me though? I'm sure somebody in this room got high before. Put your hand down, man. No, but even with weed, I seen some dudes spraying it with roach spray. Yes. Yes. Raid. Tell me. I see them take brown paper bags, they spray roach spray in it, close it up. Wait, and then they sniff it. I mean, am I saying this? I mean, y'all don't know?
Yeah.
But I'm telling you, I don't care what it is. Weed, crocodile, what Molly, sex. If it do that to me, I don't want it. Are you following me? I don't want nothing to do with it. Sister, when you're addicted. You will do anything. I've seen relatives go from the time they high come down to the time they need to get high and everything in between. They'll steal anything to get that high. So yeah, sister, they probably seen it, but they don't care. You mean to tell me the fat, chubby, sexy, beautiful black woman that started smoking crack back in the day didn't see herself losing weight? She seen it. Missing her teeth. Giving brains for dime bags. Come on, you seen that. It happened in my family. I got some relatives that wore out some damn knee pads, man, trying to get drugs. Will do anything. Anyway, I want the young people to see this. There's an article I read that just blew me away. I just said to myself, let me confirm this and talk to some elders to see if I could even kind of put it out there. You understand what I'm saying? So what they did was, in this particular slide that you're seeing right here is, you're actually seeing them in military uniforms, but I don't think I have the other slide in there where they're showing children playing video games. And if you've ever played the video games where you put on the headset and you're competing with people in different countries and you're talking to them on the phone, well, they were playing that particular game, but what they didn't know was they were actually in a real war killing real people. So when I showed this to young people, they said, well, we don't really know what that is. My mom never showed that to me.
Society can prevent those who are manifestly unfit from continuing their kind. Three generations of imbeciles are enough. I do not join in the belief that the African is our equal in brain or in power.
We are paying for and even submitting to the dictates of never increasing, unceasingly spawning class of human beings who never should have been born at all.
The laws of nature require the obliteration of the unfit.
The best way to hate a nigger is to hate him before he is born.
American eugenicists were routinely praising Hitler and holding up the Nazi eugenics program as a model for the United States economy.
Non-white races must be excluded from America. The red and black races, if left to themselves, revert to a savage or semi-savage state in a short time.
The only way possible of decreasing Negro population is by means of controlling fertility. Birth control facilities could be extended relatively more to Negroes than to whites, since Negroes are more concentrated in the lower income and education classes.
We hope that the restraint of population growth can come about through voluntary means, but if it does not, involuntary methods will be used.
There should be national sterilization for certain distinct types of our population who are being encouraged to breed and would die out were the government not feeding them.
If this movement continues, we soon may be accused of fighting poverty by eliminating the poor and overcoming hunger by removing the hungry.
For all their failures, what the eugenics movement had accomplished was to lay the foundation for the next phase of the plan. And this is where they would find the success that they had been chasing for over 100 years.
If you haven't seen my Alpha 21, I would encourage you to see it. Sit down, study it in groups. You have to go over this to know their diabolical plan. So when Professor Griff comes to town and shows you something like this, you won't be shocked. Because this is what's going on, but Bobby Hemmett hit it right on the head. He said, we're like automatons. They put the plan in motion. We don't see them anymore, and then we carry out the death sentence. And this is how they're doing it.
Excuse me.
What?
we have to understand something. This kind of information is these kind of games are out there. All right? But we have to kind of look at this and say, well, who are they designing? Who is it gearing this towards? What demographic? And then what's the purpose in order to counteract the madness? All right? We need to understand that. It's very critical. All right? So let me move on to some other things. I'm sure that question that Quojo put on the flyer, you know, has been answered. I didn't want to come here and skip over it and just talk about it a little. And but how much time do I got left? I mean, can I?
Not all the time you want. Take it.
Oh, you shouldn't have said that. No, I'm not gonna be long. I'm not gonna be. How many people have heard of the Secret Covenant before I touch on it? A few people. We have to study documents like this simply because we have to kind of piece it apart. And let me tell you, in my book, I piece it apart to the point where when you go over it, the first page, it says the secret covenant, an illusion it will be so, pardon me, illusion it will be so large, so vast, it will escape their perception. My question when I read, see, I'm very analytical and I got to look into it and change it around, flip it around, and ask questions to myself to come up with the answer that's not readily in front of you. All right? Almost like approaching it from a metaphysical perspective. All right? So we have to understand, it says an illusion, it will be so large, so vast, it'll escape their perception. They're who? They who?
Us.
No, 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 no. The vast majority of us, 85% of us, not going to see it any old damn way. So it says, those who will see it will be thought of as insane. Still us? We will create separate fronts to prevent them from seeing the connection between us. That's why we have to do the triple alphabet theory. We need to connect the dots. All right? But now, the connection between us. Who are the us that's talking here? All right? We will behave as if we are not connected to keep the illusion alive. Our goal will be accomplished one drop at a time. So as to never bring suspicion upon ourselves. This will also prevent them from seeing the changes as they occur. I said years ago they called themselves men of towardness. And when they don't accomplish that particular goal, they'll pass it on to their children. All right. This is why the bloodline is so important. All right. The White House is not the White House. That's a bloodline. And if you're not related, you cannot sit in the White House. Barack Obama is related through his white mother. We got to understand the science. All right. And the mom and the dad was working for the CIA. And then we need to figure out who this dreams of my father, and why would you even make a statement like that? Who's your real father then? Barry Davis? Barack Obama? Yeah. We will always stand above the relative field of their experience, for we know the secrets of the absolute. We will work together always. We will remain bound by what? By blood. So what did I tell you in my book, The Illuminati's Takeover of Hip Hop? It's about the blood. These are bloodlines, 13 bloodlines of the Illuminati. And they're bound by blood. So some idiots call me, told me, yo, man, yo, Griff, for real, dude. Like, is he like the Illuminati for real? Come on, man. I don't care what name you call it. Let me just ask y'all a basic question. Could it be possible that a group of white men are sitting around in secret to plan our destruction? Yeah. Fine, the Illuminati. Call it what you want to call it. Call it what you want to call it. But they're bound by blood. And they have secrets. And they are a society of men, secret societies. We will keep their lifespan short and their minds weak while pretending to do the opposite. We will use our knowledge of science and technology in subtle ways so they will never see what is happening. She said there's 7 harp installations around the globe. We don't even know where they are, much less how they work. Chemtrails. I still got people arguing with me about chemtrails. Talking about, well, I don't believe that, you know, that there's chemtrails dropping particles on our heads and this kind of stuff. Come on, man. We're going to get a big ass yellow bus for them and just watch them lick the damn window as they drive by. You understand what I'm saying? We ain't got time to sit around and keep trying to convince y'all to believe. Poisons will be absorbed through their skin and their mouths, and we will destroy their mouths, their minds, and reproductive systems. For all this, their children will be born dead. I didn't write this. This is their plan. So don't tell me that the Illuminati is faking. What would they want to do with some rappers? Stop the foolishness. They're using the rappers to control the minds of the people through the music. Poisons will be hidden in everything that surrounds them, in what they drink, eat, breathe, and wear. What they wear? If you didn't know, now you know that the skin is the largest organ. The skin is the largest organ. Whatever you put on your skin, you should be able to eat. I got hit with this one, mercury in the mouth. My mom didn't know no better. I'm brushing my teeth thinking that, okay, I'm not really getting cavities and yada, 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 and all kind of shiny stuff up all in my mouth. It was mercury. So whatever the effect of mercury does to you, I'm being affected by it right now as we speak, 53 years later. Well, I guess I didn't have teeth when I was born, so I guess, when did you start getting teeth? About six, okay, 40-something years later. We must be ingenuous in dispensing the poisons, for they can see far. We will teach them that the poisons are good, with fun images and musical tones. McDonald's, are you following me? Come on now. All of this madness, and you fell victim to it because you bought some Captain Crunch, some Lucky Charms, and some Fruit Loops. For
right now.
Thank you. It says when their teeth decay, we will fill them with metals that will kill their minds and steal their future. No, your average goddamn trip to the dentist. For real. When their ability to learn has been affected, we will create medicine that will make them sicker. Oh, excuse me, I didn't mean that. <It's>
Don't worry, he can't.
You damn right. And I said that at one lecture. I said, if Rick Ross rolled up on me and I squared off on him, I pull out a cheeseburger and be like this. No, it's good to laugh to the truth. You can digest the truth. You understand what I'm saying? But this is who the young cats be looking up to. Because he drives a Maybach. If the criteria to whether or not your daughter takes me as her mate, if the criteria is what car I drive, then I just won't be related to you, ma'am. Wow. I just won't be related to you. Because I would ask your daughter, all of the great men that adorn our walls, what kind of car did they drive? Paul Robeson, what kind of car did, let's just say Malcolm X, Dr. King, anybody. It don't matter. I mean, if I'm measured by that, then come on, man. How about the substance of the man? You was about to say something, good brother?
I want those pictures on his stomach.
White man. Well, we need to kind of dive into it. I'm glad you pointed that out. I'm not looking at the dude's stomach, but I'm just saying. Normally when I get to that, I go right past it to that one. And
run.
Yeah, run needs to run. Excuse me? Reverend Run, yeah. Okay, so let's move forward. So, the soft metals will cause them to lose their minds, and we will promise to find a cure from the many fronts, yet we will feed them more poisons. The American medical, how much time? She said I could take my time, Quojo, is that cool?
Man, just, come on, bro.
Oh, I'm just saying, man, I don't want to interrupt your cooking or anything, man.
Good, man.
All right, cool. No, he looking homeless with his hands in his pocket and shit. I'm just like, yo, I'm just asking, I'm just being respectful. Brothers and sisters, we have to start learning how to read the labels. See, there are some coded words on the labels that we can read to know what's actually genetically modified food. So if you have someone in Columbus that can have that, teach that class here, let's designate that person to do that and let's study this, all right? All right? Because you could be eating frankenfoods, genetically modified foods. I seen a fish one time that had the head of a pig. Yeah, that was this genetic modified stuff that they do, these terminator seeds and this madness. All right? All right. There's no reflection on anybody in the audience, but I'm saying, when you go to these places and you're eating that Murder King, this is not even food that you're eating. All right? These are chemicals masquerading as food. This is genetically modified food. And we need to understand aspartame, and all we need to become familiar with the terminology and the chemicals, and know how to read the labels to know the combination of things that you're putting together. All right? That's probably making you, listen, sisters, that little cute little love handle stuff that y'all got around here that won't go away, it's probably not even because of the food. I don't care. You could be doing all day long, man, exercising and all Pilates. I don't care what you do. That stuff is not going away because it's probably, the food is probably not causing it. And then you end up going getting liposuction and all this other stuff done. We need to get the spirit right first, and then we need sister circles. And brothers, we need not talk because we looking pregnant. We looking like 8-9 months pregnant, for real. It's probably the chemicals that you keep, listen, it's the combination of chemicals in the food. All right? Fluoride is in the water, brothers and sisters. Stop getting it twisted. Well, I drink distilled water or spring water, it's still there. All right? We need to learn what kind of water to get. Then you buying these expensive Kagan machines, and come on, we need to do the science for real. Someone needs to teach that class. Layla Africa, Dr. Whitaker, and a few more other brothers and sisters I know have taught the science behind this a long time ago. All right? We need to start putting these things into practice. Listen, seriously, they're getting older. Where's the next crop of researchers? Where are they at? Where's the next Dr. Francis Cress Wilson? Where's the next Amos Wilson? Come on, brothers and sisters, seriously. I'm asking young people, where's that one rapper, the one or two rappers that speak for your generation? Someone said Lupe Fiasco. Cool, I'll give him that one. Who else? No. That's not that generation I'm talking about.
A little bit,
but he's on the cusp of that generation. I don't want to hear Kendrick Lamar. No, this is what I hear from young people. Maybe y'all don't hang around young people like I do. I'm hearing Kendrick Lamar, for real. Good brother, nice MC, got skills, but Pussy and Patron, no. No. Not knocking the brother, but I'm just saying. These are very real images. My mom was used to this stuff. I mean, she died from throat cancer. Last time I seen my mom, all of this was missing because they had to cut it out. And I begged my mom, look, leave the crystal light and the stuff, the wet and soft. What is the stuff, the other stuff that you put in your coffee? Sweet and low and all, I don't know the names because I don't, Equal and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, stevia and all that madness. Begging my mom to leave it alone, but couldn't let it go. That coffee was like a drug. So I asked a question about Bill Gates' dad, responsible for one of the ones responsible for financing Planned Parenthood. And then the next slide should have been Jay-Z and Beyonce over in Africa doing a water project. I wouldn't trust them in Africa doing no damn water project. Are you following me? Making men sterile. Here, brothers at 35 years old, young cock diesel brothers can't even get it up. This is sad because of how you think in the food and the madness that you put in your body. And I was teaching a men's class one time and I told the brothers that if you hold your hand out like this, this is when you're 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60. So some of y'all are on the little bus and didn't get that. But anyway, some of y'all that did, tell the other ones, all right? I'm just saying, so if you with your dude and he and he 30 and he hanging low, we need to talk. Right or wrong? That's just a male sex education class, but I'm just saying. If you're a mom raising a son, and if you don't want to tell him, call me. My number 678-55. But anyway, but you do get the point, right? He says, our families will never mix with theirs. Our blood must be pure always, for is the way. This is just their way. These 13 families set this particular thing in. Now listen, they don't care about the other whites. So don't get it twisted. So to tell your comfortable little white friends that you got at work, don't have nothing to worry about. They ain't running anything. We need, see, but we need to stop holding the information back from them, because you know why? Minister Farrakhan has said to us, what makes us think that white people know? They don't know. We're responsible for teaching the rest of the human family. But you don't want to say anything. I gave the history of the white man in the cave on the last radio show with me and Zaza Ali. And ain't no white people call me. I said the origin of oral sex was there in the Caucasus Mountains when the dog was licking the crack in the womb of the white woman. That's just their history. But if you take too much of a damn punk to say something to your little white friend, they ain't afraid to call you a nigga. Why should you be afraid to tell their true history? I wish one of them crackers would roll up on me and ask me, what the hell did you say on your radio show? I tell them. It says, look, Bob, I'm obligated to tell you this. Now meet me at Starbucks and let's talk. And you buy the $5 cup of coffee, because I'm not spending $5 on no damn coffee. But don't be afraid. We're responsible for them. So he said, thank you. So some Afrocentrists say, well, we spent the 20 years up trapped under the ice. You still responsible for them. If that's you and they come from us, you still responsible for them. But you won't say anything to them. I'm at the airport in line. And the lady had a dog. So I'm letting people in front of me, because I don't do dogs. I'm going in the other line, and the white woman brought the little baby to pet the dog. And the dog licked the little girl. It says, oh, he likes you because he licked you. I'm like, no. You ain't licking. No. And then the little girl put a finger in her mouth. And I'm like, no, that's just, see, some of y'all are faking the funk, because you got little white girlfriends and boyfriends, and y'all seen it go down. Stop playing. Stop playing. Come on, y'all. All right. I'm not going to have that conversation. Go ahead. Kojo, when we do part two to this, can you remind me? Make a note. All right. Let me move something. Let me move quick. No, I'm not going to skip the good parts. They're using food as a weapon. We already know that. All right? Because they can determine where it rains and how much rain certain areas get. This is why you had an earthquake in Haiti. And Haiti shares that land mass with who? How come there wasn't an earthquake in the Dominican Republic?
They chose the European side.
And then all of a sudden now, they're finding gold, diamonds, and oil in abundance in Haiti. But guess who's there?
British already.
Bill Clinton
and French already.
All right, Christians, I'm not beating up on y'all, but y'all got to listen to me for a minute. A Christian is one who's crystallized into the oneness with God through the example of Christ. If that's what you claim, don't worry about the Muslims in the audience. You just do what you got to do. Sooner or later, our paths are going to cross, and we're going to say, damn, you know something? We're on the same path. You know why? We trying to get to 7. But you trying to get there 0 and 7. You trying to get there 5 and 2. You trying to get there 3 and 4. Follow where I'm going with this? All leads to the same place, right or wrong. Just different methodology. Right? If I told you that they're going to bring Jesus back tomorrow morning, tomorrow afternoon, Sunday.
What time?
Right? and I gave you the time. Yeah. Yeah. But it was going to be a 7,000 foot hologram. My grandmother will pass the hell out at the mere fact that Jesus is coming back, much less see him. But this is the technology that they're using, and the technology that they're using, because it's a psychic spiritual war going on. How virtual Charles will use an optical illusion to address yada yada yada, whoop me whoop. He will beaming the prince 7,000 miles from a studio. He will beam him, lifelike Charles. That technology was used in a movie called Paycheck with Ben Affleck. Ben Affleck created a software program for this company, all right, in order to pick up his paycheck at the end of what he had built for them. He had left clues throughout the movie while he built this thing to lead him back to this particular invention, because you know why? They didn't tell him what he was building and what they were using it for. The particular technology that he invented, he created the hologram. So his demonstration looked like this, and what he did was he picked up the computer and walked away, and the hologram stayed there. And that's the same thing your man did during Barack Obama's inauguration. And he was in 12 and 13 places at one time. Yes, sir.
Kanye did that like about 4 days ago. He was on stage with Jesus Christ.
Right. Exactly. The Tupac hologram at Coachella. But I'm saying he set it off. See, what they do is they put it out there, test it, and get you used to it and comfortable with seeing it. So when it hits you with it, it don't shock you.
Isn't that part of the reason why they're doing the chemtrails as well?
I'm not sure about that, because them chemtrails, I was sick recently. And normally I'm kind of healthy. I can get over it real quick, man. I stay sick for about 2 damn weeks. And like, what is this that I can't shake this? They've been hitting me with them damn chemtrails everywhere I've been going. You understand what I'm saying? HARP, High Frequency Active Auroral Research Program. Can y'all give me about 15 minutes? I'll be done. Is that cool? How long have we been in here? A couple of hours?
1 hour.
Okay, cool.
She said 1 hour.
No, don't do that to me. I've been in here longer than 1 hour. Project Bluebeam. You might want to look that up. Project Bluebeam is what they're using to create, along with HARP, is what they're using to create these holograms. All right? If they say Jesus is coming back Sunday, 2:30 in the afternoon, study Sun Tzu's Art of War. They're gonna strike, they'll make a noise in the east and strike in the west. Don't let these demons fool you. All right? I wanted to talk briefly about the book that I have out, Acapella Revolution, when we talk about the alchemical transformation of reconstructing the oral tradition. Alchemy is the study to transmute the lead of the ego, all right, which is your desire, into the spiritual goal of your consciousness, all right? Alchemy. Metaphysics is the science that attempts to bring the spiritual and the physical aspects of life together, and they meet at the heart chakra, which is the center chakra. Your chakras is your energy centers, all right? That's where they meet, especially with black people. That's why we're so damn sensitive. You understand what I'm saying? And we need to understand this particular concept, but I'm saying all that to fuse these two together, the method to fuse oneself with God. Above and beyond the fancy terminology and how it's constructed, fine, cool. Professor Griffin Smart, yeah, right. I'm saying to you, in a nutshell, end of the day, bottom line, you have to use that methodology to fuse oneself with God. It's the God self. Stop looking outside of the self. If you can't handle it, then you turn to your air-like. Turn to the sister in the sister circle. Turn to the brothers. We'll find the answer. Are you following me? Soon as you turn and you look outside of the self, that's when your problems start. We need to understand that for real. I put that in the book on purpose. It's one of the last things I'm going to show you, and then we can do a Q&A. I'm telling you, don't be asking me no that sideline ass questions because I'm just not answering them. I'm just letting y'all know that. I do a 3-hour damn lecture and this dude talking about, yo, so like, what's up with Flavor? I didn't mention Flavor's name one time during the lecture. I'm like, come on, man. I'm dropping deep science and I'm metaphysics and you want to know about Flavor. Yo, how much some sneakers cost he had on? No, sister, I'm for real. You seen the movie Rise? You have to see this movie. The movie inspired me so much, I did some research dealing with Rise because when I heard the term Rise, I automatically thought about the Kundalini energy that travels up the base of the spine to tap the pituitary gland or the pineal gland. I had the pleasure of meeting Jason, his brother here in the middle, because he taught me that night. We had a lecture together. Well, I did a lecture and I invited him to come speak. He said it started out really organic. They never wanted to go to Hollywood with this. It was something that they just did to stay the hell out of the streets. They just got together and danced. It grew and grew and grew. They filmed that stuff. They used to put it up on YouTube. And then Hollywood caught a whiff of it and said, ha ha, we can make some money from this. Offered some of them brothers a deal. Went to the birds from there. But the rise reminded me of the Kundalini energy. The Kundalini energy reminded me of this concept in ancient Kemet called the Ka. And this is the symbol for the Ka. The rising up of the hands, the Kundalini energy rising. All right? The Ka Ba. A lot of Muslims would know the Kaaba because the Kaaba, which is black and it sits in Mecca. And they give a large amount of energy to the Kaaba every year. And it's a reason why it's black. You need to do the deeper science. It's connected to Saturn, all right? And we need to understand the black cube and how they have taken our sacred, listen to me. You need to study how they take our sacred symbols and they use them for subversive purposes. These are our symbols, we need to reclaim them. This is ours. And we need to reclaim it. One second, Prophet. The Ka-Ba. So we need to understand this particular science. The earliest mention of the Ka is probably from ancient name of the city of Memphis. No, before that. Before that. That wasn't even a mention. All right? That's just white people taking our science and trying to twist it and put their thing on it. That's all that was. But since we got to go back and fetch it, we got to go back and get it, we got to go back through them in order to get back what they stole of ours. You invite your girlfriend over, she steal your damn bracelet and your lipstick. Now you got to go back over her house, right? To go in her house and go through her living room to get to her bedroom, open her purse and steal your shit back. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you. And we need to understand that. So every weekend, we see the car being thrown up by the referee. You understand what I'm saying? And the crowd goes crazy because it's a touchdown. And the Kundalini energy rises. Tomorrow morning, if you go to church, you will see grandma throwing up the car. Right? And what happens in church when she throws up the car? She catches the Holy Ghost, start dancing and flipping and all that kind of madness in the church, right or wrong? It's that Kundalini energy rising. There's nothing wrong with that, but it's an old concept that we have. Am I right or wrong? Well, the same thing that happened in the movie Rise, a revealing documentary of South Central Los Angeles community which captures a potent combination of artistic expressions through the exhilarating music and street dance. The movie Rise. All right. Like I said, I had the privilege of meeting the brothers and sitting down and talking. It's a fascinating story. And a lot of it they did not put in the movie, in the documentary. So right now, as I begin to close and wind this down, everyone in this room have the genetic cosmic permission slip just to be your black self. Can y'all do that for a minute? Can y'all do that for a minute? Let's listen to what the brother has to say.
So you can dance as free as you want to. It's not experience of other people acting wildly in our part of the system about it, as your valet, as your boss, as your captain, that we wouldn't have to go to school for this because it was already intended there from birth.
No, you ought to hear what he said. He said, we ain't have to go to school for this. No classes, no whatever. All we do is put the music on and do the damn thing because it's been implanted in us from birth. So I sent out a little message to the Britney Spears and Justin Timberlakes and all the rest of the little white people that steal our culture and want to dance like us and be like us. You can't practice this. Either you have this or you just don't have this. Plain and simple. Yeah. In the genetic code of black people coming from Africa to America, hip hop was locked in our genetic code. We laid down the four fundamental elements based on the four fundamental elements of the universe to unlock that code, unlock that genetic energy. If you watch the brothers, this is sacred geometry. If you watch the movement of the brothers, and they're doing the same moves in LA that they're doing in Africa, and they never met one another. How the hell did that happen? Come on, talk black to me. How did that happen? Look at the brothers. That's locked in the genetic code. You can't teach that. That's either in you or it's not, plain and simple. And you have to have melanin in order to do this. When you pull up at the damn gas station, oh, let me get 20 on 3 full of melanin. You understand what I'm saying? If you don't, you can't do this. The movements are identical. They paint their faces like we painted out, like they, these brothers painted their faces in LA. Why? Booker T. Coleman in Hidden Colors said when he first did the science of the Dogon, he said the Dogon painted 60,000 years of history on their faces. And then when he went and watched a George Clinton concert, and George Clinton in Washington, D.C., the chocolate city, landed the mothership connection down on the stage, he said, aha, that's the history of the Dogon. Am I right or wrong? Because that's how the Dogon got here. We need to understand this science. When they paint their faces, that sacred geometry, look how this brother is moving. You can't practice that, man. Same movements, watch. Same movements. As the brothers in Africa, they're doing the same thing as they're doing in LA. And you can't front on this. It shocked the hell out of the white people that was filming Rise. They didn't know what they were seeing. So when we unlock that energy inside of those four fundamental elements of hip hop that came over with us up in the Bronx, earth, air, fire, and water, b-boying, breaking, MCing, DJing, and then the fifth element is knowledge itself, which synthesizes the four fundamental elements of hip hop. And we set the hip hop thing in motion and gave birth to something that everyone is affected by. Everyone that come into music has to contemplate whether or not they're gonna deal with the vibration of hip hop. Higher infinite power healing our people. Hip hop, higher infinite power healing our people. If you didn't understand anything I said for the last 5 minutes, take a good look at this. Then give yourselves a round of applause, because this sister is walking to downtown Columbus, breastfeeding a baby, walking with a damn lamp, a rug, some Fruit Loops, a gas can, and some other shit. Are you following me? Making it happen. Being in sync with herself, her God self, and in tune with the universe and the rotation of the planet Earth. Some of y'all tonight gonna put on a tight ass dress and some heels and you're still gonna trip and fall. Right. This sister's balancing that on her head while she breastfeeding and while she walking. And if you put her in Detroit somewhere, she probably have a cell phone on doing her taxes or some shit. Are you following me? You gotta be in sync with the God self to do that. So in the Bronx, when we gave birth to this vibratory frequency, minus the tight leather pants, but I'm saying we needed that then. Are you following me? We needed, listen, them little small handheld tape recorders couldn't hold hip hop, so we went and got the biggest box that they had. I'm serious, about 12 of them, expensive as hell. And they still expensive. We put that box down and put it on 11 and we stood back in a B-boy stance because that represented us. Are you following me? We got to understand that. The frequency and the vibration that came from this particular era set something in motion. And during this particular time, those trains that went out, the tracks are like veins in the black community. Them brothers took them spray cans and tagged them trains, put them hieroglyphs on there, and we read it. Something's going on. A baby was born in the Bronx that we need to bring the gifts to. You understand what I'm saying? And it roared out of the Bronx, and you can't help it now. The cat is out of the bag. Everyone has been affected by it. So much so that the enemy crept in and had to change the vibratory frequency of hip hop to give you this gangster sexual madness to hit you at your lower energy centers, which will focus in on your sexual chakra and your root chakra to take it off. I'm just giving you, I'm just fusing that metaphysics in with spirituality, with hip hop. So you can get a full picture. Are you following me? This is what we're doing in alchemy, right or wrong? Let me tell you something. Some of y'all sitting here right now will go home and come up with some formulas that I've never heard of in order to teach these lessons. This is just my formula. The energy was hitting us here in these songs now. Brother could be 8 blocks away and we hear the bass. Yep. For us brothers, shit, our lower genitals start rumbling. That's what we want to hear coming down the street. Because maybe we got a shortage of something else. We got to have big rims, big car, big music. You understand what I'm saying? Trying to make up for something. But I'm saying we need to be heard and felt. Are you following me?
Yes,
sir. So that energy. I mean, I've been in hundreds of studios. You very rarely see black engineers. They're always white. They don't want to hear that rumble. That disturbs them, man. They can't handle that. That rumble hits you between in these two chakras, these two energy centers. Because the sexual chakra that's below that area is the area of creativity, procreativity, related to our sexual reproductive capability. That's this chakra here. The root chakra, which is the red chakra, grounds you. All right? And we need to understand that. Now, I can mention a few groups right now. The older people in here be like, yep. They probably start praising the Lord. Because if you talk about the Temptations, we can remember. The Delphonics, the Moments, the Supremes. You understand what I'm saying? I know a lot of y'all remember Johnny Taylor. You probably remember Who's Making Love to Your Old Lady While You Out Making Love. See, we remember those songs because we know what we were doing when we heard some of them groups. It was a beautiful time. Am I right or wrong? Nobody was shooting up the club. You understand? We could actually go and slow dance at some of the parties, right or wrong? Not no more. Them days are over, and I always tell young people, we need to start mating from the crown chakra down instead of meeting somebody and wanting to hit it and working your way up. You said say it again. If I met you, sister, in the mall like I did about an hour ago, and we met, rather than me trying to drag you to the hotel room and experience this, why not vibe with you from the crown chakra down? And then by the time we get to this area, it's about a year later, because we're going to have a level of respect for one another. We're going to figure out where we're going with this. You understand what I'm saying? And my spiritual mom, Queen of Fool, taught me we walk 4 seasons with one another. Huh? Of course, according to what you eat. Right? And we all can admit during the summer we wear less clothes. Brothers, you see more, right or wrong? That's when you need to start controlling things, brother. Are you following me? Brothers, you actually talk to women different in the winter than you do the summer. Because you ain't seeing all of this. You can see her mind. We can talk. Are you following me? We need to keep these things in mind. Let me move real quick. But the enemy is wickedly wise, and he already know this. This is why he took our science, which is the 7 chakras, starting from the root chakra up, Kundalini Ji going up, 7 chakras up, the 7 up. He wants to interrupt that vibratory frequency, man. And then he had the nerve to put a lemon and lime on the can. You understand what I'm saying? But he done got your science. He done took your sacred science and your symbols, and he used them for subversive purposes. All right. I'm going to bring this to the close. I don't want to talk about the Illuminati because I'm all Illuminati'd out. I really am. get the DVD or the book. I'm just all out of Illuminati. But I do want to say one thing about the Illuminati. We are the illuminated ones, not them. Give yourselves a round of applause. We are the illuminated ones. Just for Prophet and some of the other young brothers and sisters that are here, Jay-Z is not part of the Illuminati. These are the 13 families of the Illuminati. Jay-Z ain't got nothing to do with that. He's a peasant, man, a peon. If I showed you graphs and charts and families and who related to who and who owns what and the massive amount of money that they trade and whatever, you won't see. Jay-Z is like a little pebble on a beach. Don't need people like him. I mean, they use them. They'll make you rich, and after they finish using you, ring you out and put a bullet in you or poison you or discredit you. You understand what I'm saying? So this is what they do. But just for Prophet and the other young brother sitting over there, Jay-Z had to purchase a color blue to show his affiliation, his association, and his commitment to carrying out the Luciferian agenda. All right? So Jay-Z owns a color blue. It's called Jay-Z Blue. Now, I don't know. Do you have children? I didn't mean to get in your personal business. Okay. If you did, would you name them after a color?
No.
Beyonce and Jay-Z had a baby and named the baby Blue Ivy. Now, if that's not a cultic language, what is? So that's just little tidbits about the Illuminati for the younger people in the audience. And this idiot right here shot his boy in the head, I think, because he said he wanted to have the Illuminati bring him in the Illuminati and he used it as an initiation. Go figure. You can't join, look, it's not like the Boy Scouts, man. You can't join the Illuminati. You can't just walk up and join Skull and Bones. You can't do that, so just keep that particular stuff. But you start talking about it and tweeting about it, no, they will commit your ass though, like they did Michael Jackson's daughter. You'll end up in one of them padded rooms in one of them damn hospitals. All right, we're not gonna talk about that. I think I could kind of use this and end it. Big up my good brother, Black Dot, who wrote the book Hip Hop Decoded from its ancient origin. Let's give him a round of applause. Hip Hop Decoded from its ancient origins to its modern day matrix. You know, you heard me break this science down before, like I just explained with the movie Rise. We base hip hop on four fundamental elements. This is why it's so valuable to us. This is why you just can't let the enemy come in, the culture bandits come in, steal it, take it, rape it, put a price tag on it and a label on it and do what they want to with it. How many people own a car? What kind of car you drive, bro? On four fundamental elements, just respect the architect, that's all. Built on the tree of life. Coming from a black point of reference, man. The black dot. Coming from the Medunetta, the divine writing of God. They crept in and they put the matrix of hip hop next to it to neutralize it. Then they introduced gangster rap and it neutralized conscious hip hop. We have to understand that. And Black Dot said they take the lowest essence of what we have to offer and they give it maximum exposure. This is why people that can't even rap make it to the top of the charts. And they get commercials, movie deals, and all kind of stuff. Trinidad James. Like I was saying, gold all in my watch. I'm like, bruh. Come on. Now, if you would have tied that into the gold that they stole from us and you'd have went over the history of slavery, I would have gave you a pass.
Right.
But come on, man.
Nigga ain't worried about nothing.
Thank you.
You ain't be worried about anything.
Right. You sound like him, dude. Here you go. So when I heard Red Black Dot's book, I went back. I said, no, I got to find some samples to show black people because we visual people. So I pulled up this sample of the 2010 Kia Hamster commercial and I said, perfect. Now black people will get it because every time they want you to resonate with your culture, they use animals. You understand what I'm saying? To a fly beat that if you heard this in the club, you'd be like, yo, for real. She made me want to get on the drums, man. Huh? Now, I've been showing this for about 4 years now. And I show this sometimes and people still don't get it, man. It's Kia, Koreans in America. Listen, buying that neurological data that they need to figure out your buying habits so they can come up with the product that they fit. Listen, they ain't gonna dump billions of dollars into a product and not know it's gonna sell. Would you? No. So they studied black people and then they made a car called the Soul to give you back your soul. Thank you. Give her a round of applause, man. They're gonna sell it to the hood rats. I'm biting that shit. But anyway. So you hear that shit in my lecture? Like, they stole that from me. You're damn right. Anyway. Last but not least, Edward Bernays, Sigmund Freud's nephew, who actually put Sigmund Freud on the map. You wouldn't even know anything about Freud if it wasn't for Edward Bernays. Dealing with, and he's the father of the spin and propaganda techniques that he learned from Nazi Germany. Go figure, right? The conscious and intelligent manipulation of organized habits and opinions of the masses is an important element of democratic society. We got to study who the Democrats are now. All right? The demons who are running things. All right, I got a $100 bill for anybody that can prove to me that democracy works. Yeah, get goddamn hungry. Challenge me on it. 678-557-2919. Those who manipulate the unseen mechanism of society constitutes the invisible government, which is the true ruling power of their country. They have to have an invisible government because the one that you physically see don't work. Democracy doesn't work anywhere. If it worked here, why do they kill their presidents? We need to understand this. We are governed. Our minds are molded. Our tastes are formed. Our ideas suggested largely by men who we have never heard of. This is a logical result of the way in which democratic society is organized. It's organized that way, yes, but it don't work. It has never worked. It's written in the Constitution that this is a republic, right or wrong. Black people were mainly part of the Republican Party, not the Democratic Party. How did that happen? The Democratic Party and the Republican Party are two wings of the same damn bird. They're the same damn people, plain and simple. And the Tea Party, excuse me. are up in there manipulating both parties. Listen, the ones that don't have they're not a card-carrying member of the Tea Party, they working inside of the Democratic Party. Don't be fooled, these people are not stupid. Barack Obama slipped up and said one time in one of his little interviews that there's 12 people that shut the government down. But he never named them. Well, who are these people? The controlling the masses through the manipulation of the unconscious desire. What is your desire? Whatever your desire is, we're going to meet it. And while your cultural guard is down, we're going to feed what we need to feed you. So you at the club, you're getting down with your girlfriends, you done threw a couple back, you feeling nice. Your cultural guard is down. And now we're going to feed you subliminally and subconsciously what we want to put inside of you. And then it's going to sit there, and it's going to sit there, and it's going to sit there in the subconscious mind. And guess what we're going to do? We're going to trigger it when we want to trigger it. And then you're going to turn around, and according to the Willie Lynch letter, you're going to train your own children without even knowing it. So when the song come on, your little 2 and 3-year-old going to start shaking their little booties and gyrating. And you're going to say, well, where did you learn that from, you idiot? Controlling the masses through the manipulation of the unconscious desires. Let's take a look at this, and we're going to shut it down.
For some pricey limited edition footwear.
Wait. Before I show this, I want y'all to know the new sneaker came out. And the people was in line at the store to buy the damn sneaker. The brothers got into a tussle. One brother shot the other brother. You think people would go to hell home? No, they stepped over the brother and stayed in line. When Walmart had a sale, they busted the doors down at Walmart. They killed the security guard, trampled him to death. You think they went home?
No.
They continued to shop. Excuse me for yelling, but I'm saying.
For some pricey limited edition footwear spiraled into chaos this morning.
Violence here and across the country over sales of a new pair of Air Jordans. In Seattle, there was pepper spray. In California, shots fired. In New Jersey, a person stabbed. During that time, I was able to see that some of the glass doors at the mall were busted, broken out by the crowds.
You got they babies out here. It's cold, they wrapped up in blankets. What if your child got pneumonia for a pair of shoes?
I'm a shoe connoisseur. I've been getting shoes. You don't get shoes. We can't have fun, man. People trying to be on bad tennis shoes.
I ain't trying to get some
tennis
shoes. Now look like we don't get
it. I think some big meat, huh? Carry over. Work and work.
Can you imagine lining up at 4 o'clock in the morning to wait in a line in the cold that's zigzagging around the building to line up to buy a $200 pair of sneakers and the mall don't open up to 10? Where's the logic in that? And you're gonna trample someone to death and stab somebody? Come on, man. We're so far away from the God self, it ain't funny, man. We have to put something in place that's gonna bring us back to ourselves. So blessed are those that struggle. Oppression is worse than the grave. It's better to live and die for a noble cause than to live and die a slave. Asante Sana, thank you all very much for having me. I really appreciate that. Thank you. Give thanks. Just give Kojo a round of applause. I'm going to hang around for a few minutes. Let's just dialogue. I ain't even got any to do no Q&A.